Hello friends, my name is Shruti Khandelwal and today I'm going to discuss about the social learning theory. Social learning theory was discovered by Albert Bandura. He was born on 4 December 1925 in a small town called Mundane, which is in the northern Alberta, Canada. Bandura was graduated in 1949 from the University of British Columbia. While employed at Stanford, Bandura met the renowned psychologist Robert Sears, who was exploring the familiar antecedents of social behaviors and learning and aggression in collaboration with Richard Walters. This research led to a program of laboratory research into observational learning. This led to write his first book entitled Adolescence Aggression. In social learning theory, social learning theory is a theory of learning and social behavior which proposes that new behaviors can be acquired by observing and imitating others. It states that learning is a cognitive process that takes place in a social context and can occur purely through observation or direct instructions, even in the absence of motor reproduction or direct reinforcement. In addition to the observation of behavior, learning also occurs through the observation of rewards and punishments, a process known as vicarious reinforcement. When a particular behavior is rewarded regularly, it will most likely persist. Conversely, if a particular behavior is constantly punished, it will most likely desist. So, social learning theory emphasizes the importance of the environment or sexual context in which learning occurs. Social learning theory emphasizes on the importance of observing and modeling the behaviors, attitudes, and emotional reaction. Albert Bandura stressed the importance of the observational learning, imitation, and modeling. He also said that the most learning is gained by people's perception and thinking about what they experience. They learn by copying the examples of others around them. What is social learning theory? When someone uses observation or models action and consequences of those actions to guide their future actions. For example, learning to swing a baseball bat after watching the players on the TV. We learn through the observation how the players are swinging the baseball bat when we watch the TV. Learning how to use the features on your phone after watching your friend use it. In both the cases, you're observing a model performing a behavior and then later modeling that behavior yourself. And model is who or what is being observed or maybe live or symbolic. So basic social learning concepts are, there are three basic social learning concepts. There are observational learning, which is people can learn through observation. Intrinsic reinforcement, mental states are important for learning. And third is the modeling process. Learning does not lead to change in behavior. Now, observational learning. Social learning theory draws heavily on the concepts of modeling as described. Bandura outlined three types of modeling stimuli, that is, life models, verbal instructions, and symbolic. Life models, where a person is demonstrating the desired behavior. Verbal instructions, in which an individual describes the desired behavior in detail and instructs the participant in how to engage in the behavior. Symbolic, in which modeling occurs by means of the media, including movies, televisions, internet, literature, radio. Stimuli can be either real or fictional characters. Now, intrinsic reinforcement. Intrinsic reinforcement is a form of internal rewards such as pride, satisfaction, and sense of accomplishment. Next is the modeling process. Not all observed behaviors are effectively learned. Factors involving both the model and the learner can play a role in whether social learning is successful. The following steps are involved in the observational learning and modeling process, that is, attention, retention, and motor reproduction and motivation. First is attention. In order to learn, observers must attend to the modeled behavior. Experimental studies have found that awareness of what is being learned and the mechanisms of reinforcement greatly boost learning outcomes. Attention is impacted by characteristics of the observer. Example, perceptual abilities, cognitive abilities, arousal, past performance, etc. And characteristics of the behavior or event, example, relevance, novelty, affective valence, and functional values. Next is retention. Retention is in order to reproduce and observe behavior. Observers must be able to remember features of the behavior. Again, this process is influenced by observer characteristics. Cognitive capabilities, cognitive rehearsal, and event characteristics. The cognitive processes underlining retention are described by Bandura as visual and verbal, where verbal descriptions of models are used in more complex scenarios. Next is reproduction. By reproduction, Bandura refers not to the propagation of the model, but the implementation of it. This requires a degree of cognitive skill and may in some cases require sensory motor capabilities. Reproduction can be difficult because in case of behaviors that are reinforced to cause self-organizations, observations, it can be difficult to observe behavior well. This can require the input of others to provide self-correcting feedback. Newer studies on feedback support this idea by suggesting effective feedback, which would help with observation and correction improves the performance on participants on tasks. Next is motivation. The decision to reproduce or refrain from reproducing an observed behavior is dependent on the motivation and expectations of the observer, including anticipated consequences and internal standards. Bandura's description of motivation is also fundamentally based on environmental and thus social factors, since motivational factors are driven by the functional value of different behaviors in a given moment. There are three principles of social learning theory. They are: people can learn by observing the behaviors of others and the outcomes of those behaviors. Second is the learning can occur without a change in behavior. And third is the cognition plays a role in learning. There was a research done by the Bandura in 1965. He investigated aggression by using 4-year-olds as participants. The participants were allocated to one of three groups and each group was shown a different movie. In all three movies, there was a model who was being shouting and hitting a bobo doll. Each video showed the model experiencing a different consequences. Group 1, model rewarded. Group 2, model punished. And group 3, no consequences. Results were like this. The results showed that the group 1 and group 3 were far more aggressive than group 2. And although the boys were more aggressive and the gifts in all three conditions, girls in all three conditions, the girls became nearly as aggressive as the boys if they were offered a reward. So, at last, summaries of the social learning theory is watch and learn. Observing consequences of model behaviors. Social context of learning is a key. Attention plus retention plus reproduction plus motivation plus reinforcement all equals to observational learning. Thank you.